Functions are the first-class citizens in C#. Everybody knows that mantra, but not everyone knows its consequences. It is much scarier than you may think if you are only making the first steps in functional C#. This is one simple functional model, a book with zero or more authors. I will experiment with it by defining functions that apply to it. That will bring us to the point most C# programmers fail to understand. There is a simulation of a data source here. I could call this function to obtain a sequence of book objects. But that is not what I really want. I want to accomplish filtering. I will filter the books by some search phrase. However, to make this a useful function in the context of data sources, it will accept another function. The implementation will be straightforward. You can ignore it and focus on the function's signature. Is this how you know first-class functions? Every C# programmer would say that functions behave like objects, which means we can pass them as arguments to other functions. Right, that is perfectly right. And that is only the lesser half of the story. I will now show you what first-class functions really are. This is the consuming end. A function could communicate to an interactive user and obtain a search phrase. How does this function use this phrase? Well, we might turn it into a higher-order function again, asking for a data source that accepts the search phrase and returns the books. Do you see anything strange here? The function I have does not satisfy this signature. It has one additional parameter, the bare data source. I will not be able to just pass it in here. That wouldn't compile. Trying to fit that function into this function's argument list will bring us to the most terrifying piece of C# today. But be calm, we are not there yet. This function would admit it is asynchronous. It will await the data and then apply the write line function to each item. Another higher order function. That is nice. This code is the functional kindergarten. A true challenge will come when we try to invoke it. Here is the trouble. We have the data source that returns the raw items. However, this function's signature does not match the argument below. The filter function could transform the data source into a filtering function, but alas, this call is syntactically incorrect in C#. I might get away with a lambda. Yes, this would work. If you saw this solution, then congratulations. You have completed the functional programming kindergarten program. You are ready for the first day at school, the real school of functional programming. You can download the final source code from my Patreon page. I am genuinely grateful to every patron because they are helping thousands of other programmers watch these videos for free. Please visit me on Patreon. That will give you access to content that is not available on YouTube. Now back to that hard question. When you say C# supports first-class functions, then you did say the functions can be passed as function arguments, also known as the higher-order functions. That is fine. But I also want to hear from you that you can use functions as objects and then apply other functions to them to produce yet other functions as objects. Here is the definition of the function that I am using as the data source. It returns a task that produces an IEnumerable of book type objects. The filtering function, however, takes the data source and the search phrase and returns what looks like applying a common data source. Ultimately, I want a function that transforms one into another. So I said it, a function that takes a function and returns a function. This is functional programming, and specifically, it is an example of functional programming in C#. I must cut the corner in this demo and remove one of the definitions. I have just expanded the data source definition to make the next step compile. The point is that filter is the filter function as defined by the delegate type. That lets me apply the getBooks data source to it, and it will suddenly become another function that just receives a string and returns the books. Do you understand how this works? It works, so if you don't see how it works, then it is your issue, not mine. Stop the video and read this code very carefully until you figure it out. You will have to figure it out because I'm just about to make a single step that will blow your mind. I want to change the filter function into a function that just receives a string, because that is what the function I'm calling expects. To make this final advancement, I must pay a visit to my friend the filter function. It is a static method in C#, but I want it to be a function. C# supports this too. Just turn the static method into a static property that returns a func delegate. If I used delegates, this signature would be no longer than the original method definition. I wanted to show you the bare bones of functional programming in C# first. Delegates remove all this clog away. Here it is clear now. This property constructs a function that receives a data source function and a string and returns the data. When functional code is done right, most of generics go away. Download the finished source code to see how nice and clean these declarations can be. Back at the main method, you will see that now I can truly call a function on a function to get another function. That is functional programming. Now you get to it and figure it out. This is the critical part. If you don't understand why this property is essentially the same as the static method, then you don't understand how first-class functions work in C#. Don't forget to check this important lecture on your way to learning functional C#.